Dear participants, good afternoon all of you, and I welcome you for the afternoon session. I feel glad to introduce our guest of today's afternoon session, Dr. S. Suresh, to deliver his lecture on maintain a routine and take care of your body. And Dr. Suresh is a professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, and working in PA College of Engineering and Technology. He obtained in UG Computer Science and Engineering from PSG College of Technology and Masters from SKP Engineering College, Thiruvannamalai, and PhD degree in the Department of Information and Communication Engineering from Anna University. He has published more than 25 peer-reviewed journal and conference papers in the area of Big Data Analytics, AI and Machine Learning, Server Virtualization and Cloud Computing, System Modeling and Simulation. And he has a teaching experience of more than 15 years, and he has written a book by name C#.NET Programming, and he has published 3 patents, and presently he is guiding 3 PhD scholars. He has delivered more than 15 invited talks across the nation and attended more than 40 workshops. Also, he has been the member in the technical committee in many conferences and journals. Sir, we are very much delighted to have you, sir, for this session. Now the forum is yours.
Thank you, Saranapriya Madam, Dr. Saranapriya Madam. Thank you very much.
Sir.
And dear faculty students, I'm happy to be here and to give a presentation in the title, Maintain a Routine and Take Care of Your Body. I would like to welcome you all for this title. In which you maintain a routine and take care of your body. Actually, I'm going to tell you some yoga related tips to take care of your body and can make a maintained routine. So as everyone know, the title also very much related with the coronavirus only. So in this situation, how one can take care of their self and protect themselves from coronavirus, even if you are affected, how to get rid of that. This is what the major theme behind this one. Many of them ask question like, really yoga will help to get rid of this sort of problem? Actually, Ayush from central government, that also guarantees like the problem can easily be overcome by using this yoga. That's what they have produced guidelines for yoga practitioners for COVID. You can see this guidelines in ayush.government.in. There are plenty of peer-reviewed materials are there, yoga journals are there that says like how you can get rid of that by doing yogasana, meditation, and mudras and so on. So here you can see that this one, this article will tell you like what is the problem with the current COVID 19 affected person. Medicines can help us to get rid of this disease, but immunity can only be attained through using exercises only, exercise particularly yoga. So immunity imbalance is a major problem here. So yoga helps you a lot to bring your potential higher. So this is one that medicine only can able to give you that to recover from the disease only. Okay. Here also there is plenty of articles like International Journal of Yoga also have given you a clear cut idea about doing the breath activities and yoga asanas itself giving you like resistivity, immunity power, it increases, thereby you can easily recover from corona. Even if you are not get affected by corona, that doing this will get rid of that sort of a problem. So that's what this is, article says. Here you can see like doctors also, they have recommended like as follows. I have been practicing yoga for the last 2 decades. It makes us active and helps us take up new challenges. I made many doctors and friends practice it regularly at home during the lockdown period. In the absence of vaccine for COVID-19, improving immunity is the only way to fight the virus. So this is the reason why I have chosen this title as maintain a routine and take care of your body by using yoga. You can see like one more title like yoga boost immune system fight against COVID-19. There are plenty of researchers still going on, and it recommends like practicing yoga helps in getting the immunity, boosting the immunity. Okay. So what's my aim or objective in the sense, in the total session, I'm going to cover you a very simple thing. What is yoga and what are the branches of there, and what are the various important yoga related stuffs are there so that you can get practice. Actually, this title tells you slightly what is yoga, how it is originated, and what are the various branches of yogas are there. Actually, yoga is not a single term, it's a very big domain. It consists of a lot of subdomains like yoga asana, yoga kriya, hand yoga or mudra, and meditation. So most of the people have simply thought that yogasana means yoga. No, yoga is a very big discipline and very big domain, and yoga asana is one of the way. I am going to tell you about what is yoga asana, yoga kriya, and yoga mudra, as well as meditation. What it is, what is its importance, how to do that, what are the important techniques are there, so that how you can get trained and boost your immunity system and get off from coronavirus. So this is my objective. Participants, can you able to see my slide?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Thanks. Okay, thank you. So this is what my major aim, particularly to educate healthy life characteristics through yoga and how to fight against coronavirus. So what is the motivation behind my choosing this title in the sense? You can see this. If wealth is lost, nothing is lost. If health is lost, something is lost. So health does not always come from medicine. Most of the time, it comes from peace of mind, peace in the heart, peace of soul. It comes from love and love. So in order to enjoy good health, you should be, first of all, healthy, right? So what's the problem with the current people? In the name of fastest world, no people are taking care of their body. They only think like if there is any issue, disease comes at the time, they use it to take tablet, and they tell their self like, I don't have any disease, why I have to do your yoga. But World Health Organization says like health means not the absence of disease, not the absence of disease. Socially well-being, mentally well-being, and physically well-being is generally said to be the health. That is the need. So some people used to say, how can I go to gym, how to buy some things and so on, when to do such a questions they used to ask. And in the lockdown period also, I cannot go outside. So the complete solution, one and only solution, is yoga. So what you need to do is, you don't have anything, merely the self-interest is sufficient to be the enough to do the yoga. So health is not the chance, it's our choice, right? Choose best. Okay, what are the methodologies I'm going to teach you for giving immunity against coronavirus? So there are plenty of methodologies are there. One is yoga asana, and another one is yoga kriya, and another one is yoga mudra or hand yoga and meditation. So I am going to teach you four methodology. Yoga asana, that is how to keep your body position, bending, forwarding, such a activity, that's what keep your body in a particular posture. That's what yoga asana. Yoga kriya in the sense, how to take care of your inner body. say for an example, how to clean your digestive system, how to clean your colon, how to clean your nose, we don't do right because it's not possible. We think even exercise don't suggest such a thing. It ever gives any idea about how to clean your colon, how to clean your digestive system and so on. But yoga completely gives the solution for all of this thing. That's what the greatness of yoga. Yoga mudra, actually, whenever you would have seen Lord Shiva, who is in Sin Mudra, right? That is said to be the hand yoga. By doing the hand yoga also, you can get the energy and get the immunity power also. We will discuss about what is the difference between yoga, yoga asana, yoga kriya, yoga mudra, meditation. Meditation means of transforming the mind. Meditation also a very important thing that easily tells you how boost your immunity power. Meditation, that's what really wonderful thing. At the time I will tell you what is the greatness of meditation. Meditation is be poised, be calm, don't do anything. That's the interesting thing. So these are all the methodologies I'm going to teach you so that you can learn what it is. So here now we come to know about what is health. Many of the people simply think in the absence of disease is said to be the health. I don't have any disease, why should I mind about my health? But the World Health Organization clearly says like health is a state of complete physical, mental, social well-being and not merely the absence of disease or infirmity. So guys, now you can ask yourself like, are you socially, mentally, physically well-being? If not, then you are not perfect, right? You are affected by disease. Physical well-being leads to mental well-being, leads to social well-being. Why should I mind my health? Life is 10% of what happens to you and 90% of how you react to it. So take care of health is most important. Let me tell you a very simple snake story. Once this snake, the very furious snake, big snake, what happened? It saw the sword. So it simply moves on the edge of the sword. So as you know, like you can see like what is the solution. So there is a plenty of scars and blood leaking. What the snake thought that, oh, how dare you sword through your edges. You made me scare. I won't spare you. Such a thing it maintains, it comes in its mind. Then it start to do the same thing. And it start to fight with that. What would be the result as you expect? Finally, the snake did. So that's what they are telling. Life is 10% of what happens to you and 90% of how you react to it. First of all, we should know about what is our body system. Our body system consists of three important aspects. One is a physical body and another one is mind. The third one is spirit, soul. So these are all the three important thing that is very important. Physical body, through food you can take care of physical body. Mind, through education and knowledge you can make it a mind. Spirit, through prayer and love you can make it good. Which one? Spirit. So what I'm going to present in the sense, how to enhance and take care of physical body system. Physical body system, how to take care of through yoga. Once if you take care of physical body system, it will take care of mind and then automatically the mind will take care of a spirit or soul. So you should know about your body through the chakra level. Actually, as per our ancient people, our body made up of seven chakras. Those seven chakras are given here. Each and every chakra is responsible to take care of such a glands and the energy flow from low level to upper level. So that's what the center in our bodies in which energy flows through. Blocked energy in our seven chakras can often lead to illness. So there is a energy flow is not good and there is a block in the chakra level. That's what name it as some stress, chronic disease and so on. there are plenty of diseases are there. The reason behind this one is because the chakra is blocked and the energy is not properly flowed. That's the reason. If you take a child, you can see like all seven chakras are working greatly. They are getting the energy from the ether space. So what is the need of yoga? The wonderful questions here, look at this. Buddha was once asked, what have you gained from meditation? Because meditation also one part of yoga only, that's why. What have you gained from meditation? He replied, nothing. However, Buddha said, let me tell you what I lost: anger, anxiety, depression, insecurity, fear of old age and death. Interesting, right? I didn't gain anything. I lost a lot of things. The answer you seek never comes when the mind is busy. They come when the mind is still. That's what consciousness, right? Controlling your brain is the toughest thing. That thing can be easily done with the help of doing yoga, because yoga is a practitioner. The body is the house of God. Whomever shall know their self shall know God. So the need of yoga. What is the yoga really can do? See, this diagram simply shows you what's really happening for a lot of different people. See, when you are waking, your body and conscious minds continuously keep working, right? When you are sleeping, dreaming, active, that state also active state, but ordinary sleep is a dream sleep. Next level is a deep sleep, that is without dreaming you are sleeping, but that's also not a great one. When you go to the fourth state, that is fourth state, that's what you are away from all the things, negative things. That's what fourth state, right? The entire purpose of the yoga is to attain this state. The one who lives in three cities, okay? This is what yoga can give you. Yoga, what is yoga? See, most of the people simply think like yoga asana is called as a yoga, but that's not true. Yoga is said to be the union of the individual consciousness or soul with the universal consciousness or spirit. It is the wellness and wholeness of spirit, mind and body. Yoga means wellness and wholeness of spirit, mind and body. Yoga is 5,000-year-old Indian body of knowledge, right? That drills, exercise are recently introduced by foreign culture. Our culture is like 5,000-year-old Indian body of knowledge. Yoga is not only meant as a physical exercise, a twist, turn and stretch. It is a holistic way of life that integrates all elements of ancient knowledge. You can see like this saint, what he is doing in the sense, is doing meditation and he is getting the energy from ether space. And Lord Shiva is a very good person known for meditation. And he is said to be that king of many art, right? And he is having the third eye chakra, right? So I told you like, what is yoga? Yoga is not yogasana. Yoga is union of individual consciousness or soul with the universal consciousness or spirit. See, look at this yoga. Yoga asana is a part of the yoga, or yoga asana is one of the way to attain the aim of the yoga. What is the aim of the yoga? Wellness and wholeness of spirit, mind and body is said to be the yoga. Yoga is a practice of tolerating the consequences of being yourself. Yoga is about clearing away whatever is in us that prevents our living in the most full and whole day. It is a prayerful discipline, uniting the body, mind and soul. Aim is prayerful discipline, uniting the body and mind and soul. What are the benefits of yoga in the sense? See, they have listed a plenty of things for body, mind, soul and everything. They have given lot of things: weight management, improved digestion, circulation, body deactivation, pain and tension relief. For mind, improved intuition, improved concentration, neutralized stress, improved memory and so on. Yoga for good health, lost weight, increased flexibility, relieve stress, improve immunity. It's well-being, better sleep, provides concentration, anxiety and depression relieving from. These are all the advantages of doing yoga. So far what I discussed in the sense related to this title, how you can take care of yourself through yoga, I told you what is yoga and what is the importance of yoga, and it is our ancient ancestors' knowledge, and we discussed in the plenty of other materials that it can give you the immunity, thereby get rid of the coronavirus, and it is a proven technique, like doing yoga will get rid of the coronavirus and increase your immunity. Now I'm going to tell you the methodology. What are the methodologies are there such that I can attain the aim of the yoga, so that I can give boost my immunity, such that I can get rid of the coronavirus. First one is yoga asana. What is yoga asana? Yoga asana, physical posture enhance the body's function. See, look at this. This is one of the physical posture. 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 Physical posture enhance the body's function. Body's function. That's what's said to be the yoga asana. What is the importance of yoga asana? See, a lovely terminology. The strength of a tree lies in its ability to bend. See, actually, our spine should be so flexible. Your age can easily be identified by using that stiffness of your spine. If you touch a kid's spine, it's similar like a rubber. That much flexible you can see from the kids. However, as we grow, keep grow, as we don't do any exercise or some yoga or some other flexibility activity, our spine start make becoming a stiff one. Automatically, it is equivalent to calling the disease to our body. That's what they are telling. The strength of a tree lies in its ability to bend. Similarly, when you are doing the yoga asana, it will give you the flexibility. Yoga is about clearing away whatever in us that prevents our living in the most full and whole day. What is the importance of yoga asana? Why you need it? See, what the yoga asana can do in the sense to keep the chakra energy flow freely. So when you keep doing the yoga asana, the chakras keep starts works, and its blockage is freed, and that energy level will start going from bottom to up and up to bottom. First of all, you should know about what is the working logic of yogasana. Okay, this is a very simplest logic. Actually, blood consists of red blood cells, RBC, and white blood corpuscles, right? The RBC are said to be the cops. Whenever there is any problem at that place, blood goes, and that RPC will fight with the disease and get rid of that and cure everything, right? What the yogasana does in the sense, when you are in the pressure, certain asana, there is some place get affected by pressure. Automatically, if there is a pressure at the time, what you can expect is you can expect a blood. When the blood comes, the red blood cells start curing that place. This is what the working logic. Wherever the pressure comes, that blood goes there and RPC will do its work. So now you come to know about what is yoga asana, what is its goodness, and how the yoga asana helps one to boost the immunity. I'm going to tell you now 10 yoga asana poses for the beginners, so that you can easily learn and do it, such that you can increase the immunity. The first one is very simple. Name it as a reverse prayer hand, Viparita Namaskarana. See, look at this, how you have to do this. This is Namaskara, this is a reverse Namaskara. So it help you breathe better, maintain your metabolism and energy level. As our age keep increasing, metabolism levels start to get affected. But when you do yoga, it keep increasing the good metabolism level. Tree pose. This is also very simplest thing. What you need to do is you have to stand it in a single leg. You can do it for 1 minute or 2 minutes. Afterwards, again, this leg. So that your leg become very stronger. The same thing, the pressure comes, you can feel the pain. The pressure comes, the RPC comes there, and the red blood corpuscles start working the problem, and you will get the immunity. So benefit of the tree poses are it boosts concentration, stretches, strengthens, develops. The third one is Vajrasana. I should first of all explain this Vajrasana. The name Vajra comes from Lord Indra. He has such a thing, Vajra. Means that unbeatable. So similarly, if you do this asana, the outcome of that asana will be similar, like your legs become vajra. Vajra means unbeatable, very strengthened. So how to do that? That's what they are telling this way. See, first step, second, third, fourth. Or the Muslims, you can see, like when they are doing the prayer, they always use to sit in this asana. Even if you do this asana, you can see a plenty of goodness. You will get your thighs in a correct shape, not very muscular, lean and length, and very goodness. You can see this. It will give you a lot of advantages. Stress reliever, body toning, joint ache healer, constipation healer. Next one is Padmasana. Why Padmasana? The word comes in this. You can see this foot is up to the sky. Sir, it looking the sky, right? That's what. As this asana looks like lotus, this name comes at Padmasana. You can see like our Prime Minister Modi, who is doing this Padmasana. And that's what I said. See, when he do the asana, he is in this one of that mudra also. Name it as hand yoga mudra. So, see, look at this. One leg should be on another leg's thigh, and another leg foot should be on another leg's thigh, so that it keeps your spine very straight, erect. See, look at this, how to do this, they are telling. See here, this is also very good. Open up the hip, restore energy level, promote peace of mind, and so on. Child pose or balasana. Child pose or balasana. This pose, the child in this pose only, the child in this mother's when it is in unborn baby, it sits in the following way. That's what the term comes, child pose. Bala, child. Balasana. The balasana is a resting pose that can precede or following any asana. See, look at this. Your forehead should touch the head. Most of the people simply think like doing yoga asana, in the sense, suppose some asana is there, they simply for some seconds they think like they are doing asana. That is not enough. What yoga asana says, in the sense, suppose when you are stand, you don't feel any shake, right? Suppose when you are stand in a single leg, you feel some shake, right? So comfortably, if you can stand, if you can do the asana for 30 seconds, 1 minute without any shaking, then only it is said to be the yoga asana. Don't simply think when I bend, when you give the stretch, it is said to be the asana. So relieves back and neck pain when done with the head and. Next, you can say Halabasana. This is very toughest thing if you have a big belly. Normally most of the people feel very tough to do this one, because this part, bending this part, needs continuous practice. So continuous practice and perseverance will help you to do this. So look at this, what this lady doing. Halabasana in the sense, in Tamil, kalapai asanam. And the vivasayathukala kalapai vachu uluvaangalla அந்த ஆசனத்துடைய டைப்பாக இருக்கிறதுனால இதுக்கு ஹலபாசனா அப்படிங்கிற பேர் உண்டு. யூ நீட் டு டச் திஸ் கிரவுண்ட் அண்ட் லுக் அட் திஸ் அண்ட் ஒன் மோர் திங் இஸ் நீடட் வென் யூ டூ திஸ் எக்ஸசைஸ் யூ ஷுட் செக் இட் அவுட் யுவர் லோயர் சீக் ஷுட் டச் யுவர் லங்ஸ் டச் யுவர் லங்ஸ் தட் நாட் ஷுட் பி கிரியேட்டட். So it improves the digestion and appetite, strengthens the abdominal muscle, spinal cord strong and flexible. And one more thing, seated forward bend or Paschimottanasana. This is also a very toughest thing, but if you keep doing day by day, gradually your system start bending. See, what you need to do is See, first position, second position, third, fourth. You should touch your forehead, should touch that joint. But very tough, day by day, you can start practicing this. This reduces fatty deposits in abdomen. If you want to reduce your belly, you can keep doing this. Some people used to do as follows. They use it to bend. If they don't bend fully, they tell someone to stand on above them. Good for constipation and digestive disorder. Next, Nagasana. Naga means snake. That's what the cobra bows. You can see like a snake's tail and its face. What you need to do is you have to sleep. You have to sleep. Then put your leg around your waist and just stand up. Just up. So you look at this foot. It should be here. And your hip also should touch the ground. And you should up. Your face should be up. So, benefits of cobra bows: stretches muscles in shoulders, chest and abdominal, improves circulation of blood and oxygen, especially throughout the spinal and pelvic region. Sirasasana. Many of the people feel like doing Sirasasana, this is the first thing, but this is one of the very, very simplest asana only. See, actually blood has to go from bottom to up, but unfortunately blood always comes to most of the people from up to head to bottom only. That is not preferable. That is why bald head, a lot of things comes. So as in the diagram, if you can able to stand in this Sirasasana, a lot of advantages are there. All head related issues will be overcome easily. This is Artha Sirasasana. Artha means padi, means half of the Sirasasana. If you stand this way, then balancing is somewhat tougher. This is very easier. So non-kadavul, Arya. So Sirasasana. Then suppose you are having bald head, this asana helps you to grow hair and other things also. And now blood comes from bottom to your head, so that your brain become thing, and your teeth, no, teeth blood, that everything gets stronger. Eyes also get stronger. Balances hormones, stimulates the nervous system, increases mental alertness plus clarity. So this is what Sirasasana or headstand. Sarvangasana. See, you can see a small difference between this Sirasasana headstand. Head touches the floor. Right? See here, look at this. How the body is bent. Shoulder touches the ground. That's what Sarvangasana. If you want all part of your body get good health, then you can go with the Sarvangasana. If you want the head to be the primary part, then you can go with the Sirasasana. So you can see like first, second, third, and fourth. This is the position. You need to simply up and up your leg. Now look at the shoulder on the part here. Right, it stimulates thyroid and parathyroid glands. It relieves constipation, strengthens shoulders, arms, and spine. This is what Sarvangasana. Sarvangasana in the sense, ella angangalukkum yetra oru asana abdingiradhu oru meaning. Okay, now so far we have discussed about yoga asana. Actually, four methodology I am going to teach you. One is yoga asana, next one is yoga kriya, and another one is hand yoga, and the fourth one is meditation. Okay, see, you should know about one thing. When you do the yoga asana, sweat should not come, but in doing exercise sweat comes. Then when you do yoga asana, it never asks you food, but the exercise ask food. When you do yoga asana, it reduces heartbeat, everything. But doing exercise will increases heartbeat, higher heartbeat, and body get cooler when you do yoga asana. But when you do exercise, your body temperature start increases, right? Okay. What is yoga kriya? body cleaning technique. Inner body part cleaning technique is said to be the yoga kriya. Inner body cleaning means that nose, you want to clean your nose, right? You want to clean your colon. Colon means that shit part. You want to clean your foot pathway. How it is possible? See, actually yoga gives you a good idea, but no exercise have ever suggest any idea for inner part cleaning. What is cleaning kriya? Cleansing kriyas, internal purification of the human body in depth. Powerful way to detoxify and purify your body from the inside out. Six main groups of satkarmas or yogic cleanser as follows. The first one is neti. Neti, it is widely known as nasal cleaning, jala neti, sutra neti, I will tell you. And another one is tauti. Tauti means taking a cloth a little bit lengthier, 2 meter, 3 meter lengthier tauti made up of cotton, and send it to your footpath, right? So that it will clean the lime scale. And nauli, abdominal massage, basti, colon cleaning. That is, some people used to do, right, enema can. That's what said to be the basti or colon cleaning. Then kapalabhati, purification and vitalization of front lobes. Tratka, blinkless gazing. Let us see, like, what is the advantages of going with that cleaning kriya or body cleaning or yoga kriya? In the sense, the effects can be summed up in one word: purification. Inner body part purification, and the different system of the body have been purified. The overall result is that energy can flow through the body freely. One's capacity to work, think, digest, taste, feel, experience, etc., increases, and greater awareness develops. Right? These are all some of the ideas that this diagram shows you what is each and everything. But I am going to visually explaining everything. Neti, in the sense, neti, there is two neti is there, sutra neti, jala neti. Jala neti in the sense, take a water in a pot and put it in the nose. That's very hard, right? But there is a provision is there, right? You can put the water. That water should be like should consist of a little bit of salt, so that it can remove that all things from nose, right? Next, sutra neti. Sutra neti means you should take some tube, very simple tube. You should put it in one nose and should bring it through the mouth. That is also one way of cleaning that any obstacle between this one. Next, tauti, take a cloth and send it to your footpath and try to remove the lime scale. And nauti means that stand in this way and try to pull your entire body system, that stomach, so that your inner parts get pressure and it will start doing work. Okay, let us first of all see, like, what is neti. Cleaning of nasal passage, nasal passages, and is done one of the two ways. See, look at this. It is available. Cleaning of nasal passage, that you can take it in any part and you can slide your head in this way and put it in the nose. When it will commit by another nasal. Suppose another way is you can take a rubber tube, very simple rubber tube size sutra. Then you can put it in the nasal, nasal pathway to that mouth pathway. See here, it shows. You can ask me one question, sir, can you do it? Yes, I have done everything. Even if you want the physical demonstration, I can able to do jala neti and sutra neti. If you have any running nose and doing jala neti or sutra neti, it will immediately get rid of such a disease. And it is good for sinus problem also. Tauti. See, tauti in the sense there are plenty of tauti is there. One is like take a drink, water. You can take a plenty of water to the stomach and take the same water outside so that all the acidity is deposited in this stomach will come out. Or vastra tauti means, vastra means tuni. Vastra tauti means you should take 5 meter length and 1 meter limited size of cotton cloth, and you need to send it to your food pathway, food pathway, right? Then you have to rotate it so that the lime scale in the border will be cleaned so that organs will work function good. Say, look at the stomach. Why clean the stomach? Next, abdominal massage. Pressurize the internal organs. See, look at this. What you need to do is, actually kids used to do this sort of simple thing, right? We can also try to do that, but that's not possible if you have a big belly or something. What you can do is, you can start doing simple level day by day. It gets a practice and you can able to do this. So if you do this, all the parts are get pressurized and start working in a good way. That's what abdominal massage, pressurize the internal organs. Colon cleaning, to remove the non-specific toxins from the colon. See, this is how our colon looks. Even though we are wearing a good dress, pant, shirt, everything, but in real thing, you can see like the following things. See, still shit is there. Shit. Unclean the shit. So your colon in this way only looks. That's what someone, when they speak, you can feel the bad smell. When gas comes, that gas is so odd. So what you can do is, to remove non-specific toxins from the colon, you can buy a enema can from any place. You can go and ask enema can, 50 rupees the can is. You can fill it with the water. Then you can insert this through the colon, this side. Then you can have to hang it at the place, some place. And if you stand this way or this way, then all the water goes inside the colon. Once it goes inside, then it start cleaning. Any clog is there, block is there, then it smoothens and all the shit comes out easily. So this is what busti, colon cleaning. Trataka means that blinkless gazing. Suppose you want a concentration and you want a sleep. What is the problem with the sleepless nights in the sense thoughts? No, that the thoughts keep agitating from one thought to another thought. If you are still with the thoughts, then sleep will simply come. You will get a deep sleep. So what you can do is, see, you can do as follows. You can have a candle like this. At your eye level, you can ignite that candle. Okay, thereafter you have to stare it. Probably you can go with any of the asana, padmasana if possible do, otherwise vajrasana you can go, and if possible go with the mutra. I will tell you what is mutrasana. This sin mutra you can go and try to go for 5 minutes. If you are a new person and stare for 5 minutes, 10 minutes, then you will face eye drop, right? You will start cry, but day by day, if you start doing that, your body will accept this changes and no problem. The advantages are many. To reduce condition like eye strain, headache, astigmatism, myopia, as well as the early stages of cataract are also cleaned by this. Okay, so far we discussed about the two things. One is yoga asana and another one is yoga kriya. The third one that we are going to see is yoga mutra or hand yoga. Sometimes when you are in a bus or a car, you don't have a place to do this yoga asana, yoga kriya. I want to get the same functionality, helpness of this yoga asana, but without doing such a gusher, in the sense you can go with hand yoga. So as per our Hindu Vedic, they says like, what does it mean mutra? Position of the body that have some kind of influence on the energies of the body or your mood. Mostly the hands and fingers are held in some position, but the whole body may be part of the mutra as well. Now you can easily see hereafter whenever go to any temple you can see like not only Lord Shiva, Lord Venkateshwara or Parvati, Lakshmi, you can see like small god also in a particular position. Look at their hand is always in some mudra. That mudra helps them to give energy or water flow level, air level or panchabhutas, to keep panchabhutas levels same. So they also have some mudra. Mostly the hands and the fingers are held in some position, but the whole body may be part of the mudra as well. Mudras are open to chakra or to open chakras. See, look at this. If you take your hand, as per our Vedic, this finger is considered as Agni, fire. This is considered as air, and this is for ether, Akasha. This is for Prithivi, and this is for Jala, water. So when you make a knot, that closed electrical circuits of the susceptible channel in physical and etheric bodies are also known as mudras. So what you are doing is, you are simply making a knot. You are making a knot from this one, and this knot helps you, what? Mudra. And the particular mudra gives you particular energy. See, you can see like how the part of our hand and each every part of the hand, how it is related to our human body system, brain, air, lungs, lower back, upper back, and everything. Mudras are the hand positions or physical gestures that have an effect on the energy flow of the body. You can see the Lord Shiva is a well-known person for all of special kind of things. He is the inventor of yoga. He is the inventor of yoga. Through Nandi and from her daughters only, that yoga known to the world. There is people used to say this story. The ancient practice of yoga links the hand mudras to the changing spiritual and mental aspects of the person. You can see this. This is also a mudra. This is a mudra. This is also a mudra. You can see like when they dance, classical dance, you can see these sort of mudras. And this is a sin mudra, widely known mudra, for, especially most chosen for concentration. Okay. The mudra affect consciousness, mood, and energy. Each finger is associated with a different sensitivity, and that the finger endings lock into mudras, create susceptible energy shifts due to this different energy circuit connections. Pressing on finger endings also simulates brain sections relating to different qualities. Benefits of yoga mudra. You can see like disease are caused due to an imbalance in the body, which in turn is caused by lack or excess of any of the five elements. According to Ayurveda, disease are caused due to imbalance in the body, which in turn is caused by lack or excess of any of the five elements. Five elements in the sense, fire, ether, water, air, and so on. Right? That's what five elements, panchabhutas. Our finger have the characteristics of these elements, and each of these five elements serve a specific important function within the body. The fingers are essentially electrical circuits. The use of mudra adjusts the flow of energy, affecting the balance of air, fire, water, earth, ether, and accommodating heating. Chin mudra, very simple. See, look at this. This index finger. What is index finger? Here, let's see. Index finger, air and fire, right? Sin mudra, air and fire is involved. This is fire, this is air. You need to touch it. When you touch it, then fire passes. Fire passes to this air, right? However, if your entire part of the finger touches this, then you are burning. Burning different, heating different, right? You are simply heating the air. So this is gives sin mudra. Thumb and index fingers need only touch together without exerting any pressure. Any pressure you should not exert. Better retention, concentration power. Sin mudra. Next, Surya mudra. See, actually, this is a fire. What is this? This one. This is water. This is, let us see. this is earth, prithvi. This is prithvi, earth. See, this is a fire, this is a earth, prithvi. What you need to do is you need to give a pressure and not a slight touch. See, that major part of the finger is touching this earth. So it is burning. It is burning, which is said to be the Surya Mutra. So it is burning the earth. Our body is earth. Bend the ringer finger and press it with the thumb. Increases the element of fire in the body. So the Surya Mutra is known to help the body deal with the excess fat. If there is a excess fat, then it start reduces it. Then Vayu Mutra. See, this is air. This is air, and this is a fire. So what now we are doing in the sense, now you are giving pressure and touching, not merely touching. Most part of that this finger is now touching. You can see that. Bend the index finger and press it with the thumb. But previous in case we only touch two fingers, balances the air element within your body, balances air element within your body, releases excessive wind from stomach. This is said to be the Vayu Mutra. Next, Varuna Mutra, Mutra of water. This is said to be the Varuna, this finger. And this is said to be the fire finger. You need to simply touch so that the water level is heated, not fired. Heated. So this sort of mutra is said to be the Varuna Mutra. Balances the water content in our body, cures all skin issues like dryness, skin disease and skin infections, relieves and prevents any muscle pain that you may suffer from. You can ask me a question, how long I have to do? You can go with 1 minute, 2 minute, 3 minute, 5 minutes, you can go. You can take, you can see another mutra, name it as Samana Mutra. In Tamil, in another word, it is said to be the Pandri Mutra. See, all the five fingers should touch with each other. This gusher will give you the face of pig. That's why it is said to be the Pandri Mutra. The special about this mutra is all the five elements are touching with one another. What it makes? It makes all the five elements equilibrium of five elements in our body. So if any part of your any element in your body is not equalized, it will do Samana Mutra. So I have completed three methodology of yoga. One is yoga asana, and another one is yoga mutra, and another one is yoga kriya. Now it is the time to discuss about meditation. This is also a very interesting thing, what it can do, what is the usage of this. Most of the times our lords are always in meditations. We can claim meditation is ours. Why? Because Buddha and Lord Shiva, Narayana, every persons they always used to be in meditation. No foreigners, I think, they ever invented this sort of meditation, and they practicing meditation. Next, yoga meditation. So let us recap once again what we discussed so far. We are discussing the title, maintain a routine and take care of your body, as corona virus is very worst one. So we need to give the immunity to our body. The tablets, medicines can only get cure from the disease, but get rid of the corona need good immunity for our body. So to maintain a routine and take care of our body, we need to do the yoga, which is better than exercise. Why? Because exercise needs a drill and a sweat and a good food and so on. Physical places are also needed, but in your home alone time you can do yoga, which is very easier to do that, right? Simply 6 feet square feet. 6 feet is sufficient enough to do this sort of activities. So I said the motivation, inspiration, what is yoga, what is the difference between yoga, yoga asana, what is yoga asana, what is yoga kriya, what is yoga mudra. We have discussed so far. The last one is meditation. We will discuss the meditation and we will have some interaction. Next, yoga meditation. Meditation, what is meditation? Meditation is a means of transforming the mind. Transforming the mind. Actually, what happens? Let me tell you what really happens in this. See, actually, our body know for every 6 months that body cells keep changing. Every 6 months, for every 6 years, for every 7 years, 7 years, 7.5 years, brain cells start changes. Start changes. So whatever the brain cells creating, the thoughts, whatever we are having, that starts from Kundalini and through the spine, it goes to mind. Whatever the thought that we are seeing, talking, whatever the thoughts we are having, that goes from brain to spine and to the body. So this is how the working logic behind mind as well as that body. Okay, so suppose you, in your mind, bad things are there. Aggressiveness, vulnerable words, thoughts are there. Then what you can do is, by doing the meditating, you can dilute the seriousness of this thoughts of mind. That's what the interesting thing. If you start doing the meditation in the sense, it will dilute the seriousness of the thoughts which is available in your brain. Okay. So meditation is a means of transforming the mind. Approach to keep your brain calm and clear. Develop concentration, clarity, emotional positivity, and a calm seeing of the true nature of things. So you can see, like, Lord Shiva is doing meditation. Krishna, Lord Krishna, doing meditation. Narayana doing meditation. They start doing meditation for years, 100 years. They start doing that meditation. Child's also very good for meditation. That is particularly concentration. They can be concentrate in a particular state for 30 minutes, sometime 1 hour. Yogis will do the same thing. They are capable of doing 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hours. That is, you have to have a thought of particular thing for more than 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 years. That is mindfulness techniques, concentrative techniques. Seeing the movie also very good one. When you see a movie, that sometimes it's a very good movie, no? You forget everything around you and you simply concentrated on the particular movie for 2 hours, 2.5 hours. Then you say, like, one thing, like, oh, I feel very relaxed. Because mindfulness technique, that is similar like meditation, that gives the calmness. So this is what the working logic behind your meditation, right? So meditation is a means of transforming the mind. Develop concentration, clarity, emotional positivity, and a calm seeing of the true nature of things. The wisest teacher lives within you. What you need to do is, when you calm your mind, you can see the teacher within you. The body is the house of God. Whomever shall know thyself shall know God. Meditation aimed to invoke divine within you. Buddha is a very good example. He used to do the meditation very frequently, so that you can see, like, his face is so glaring, right? So you may ask that question, what is why Rajinikanth, this picture is here. The true story, let me tell you. This is a movie named it as Annamalai, in which he acted. So in a particular room, he used to catch the snake. Unfortunately, what happens in the sense, the snake will goes up to the up to his head. What happens in the shooting places, in the sense, they want to shoot the situation like the movie, that the snake has to move on his body and has to go on his head, like how it is in Lord Shiva shoulder. So that snake man simply thought, like, how it is possible, and so on. He is afraid of, will the snake will ride on a Rajini body and will go and be in the same position. But unfortunately, Rajini is a very good meditated person. His aura is very good aura. So when the snake man put the snake, that snake automatically goes through his body and put it in the position. Everyone dashed. So that's what I have included. So when you start doing that meditation, everything, your body chakra level increases, then energy level increases, you will start getting the energy. Your body also get energized. Mind is so noisy. Keep it in one's control is so challenging. Arjuna Mahabharata. We cannot see our reflection in running water. It is only in still water that we can see. Quiet the mind and the soul will speak. This is a wonderful definition. Quiet the mind and the soul will speak. Sometimes we are getting the intuition, right? Intuition means that enamo nadakka podu appdi nammale solran la. Who says that? Our soul speaks. Intuition. So when you start doing your meditation level, some people used to say, if you keep doing the meditation level and go inner level, you can see your previous birth. People used to say like. So as your mind is very busy and fight for some other thing, you are not speaking to your soul, which is a lightning. Meditation, what is not? Meditation is absolute inner silence. Absolute inner silence. Meditation is not a visualization, chanting, yogi posture. Meditation is absolute inner silence. So when you want to be a meditator, how you have to be? So already we have discussed, Buddha was once asked, what have you gained from meditation? He replied, nothing. However, Buddha said, let me tell you what I lost: anger, anxiety, depression, insecurity, fear of old age and death. The secret of life is to have no fear. So it keeps you everything away from that. See, actually, some of the waves that presence in our brain, ECG signals, through ECG signals, you can get this delta, unconscious. See how the waves look like. How the waves look like. See, look at this, delta waves, theta waves, creative subconsciousness. Creative subconscious, that is painting, writing, composing. At the time, you can see like theta. Alpha, relaxed alertness. Relaxing, playing sport, listening to music. See, look at this waves, the type of waves. Delta, theta, alpha. You can see like when problem solving and communicating, at the time you can see like beta waves, disturbed waves. When you are doing meditation, you can see the following thing. See, look at this. It is not doing meditation. It is not doing meditation. Here you can see that this is a meditation doing spectrum. Meditation doing meditation, right? You can see that energy level. Energy level, that alpha, beta, gamma value level. Here you can see a plenty of level. The left images show the brain during concentrative meditation, while images to the right show the brain during non-directive meditations. Benefits of meditation. There are plenty of benefits of doing meditation. One is reduce pain, reduce feeling of depression, increase blood flow, provides a sense of calm, help reverse heart disease, and so on. How to start meditate? You can see this here. See, legs are, hand should be here, and spine should be straight, and the head should be like this. It explains. Cross leg. Either you can go with Padmasana or you can go with Vajrasana. Hands right on top of the left and two thumbs touch together. And three, back straight. Spine should be straight. Four, shoulder balance. Five, neck straight. Tongue stick up. Eyes semi-closed or closed. Some people use it to say like om and so on, but people say like meditation is about the inner silence and it's not about chanting. Don't do any chanting. Don't do any chanting. Different type of meditation thought process. Breathing. Suppose at the time doing of meditation, you can concentrate on your breath. Conceptual level, some physical thing, or awareness, mantra chanting, and so on. Many type of meditations are there. One is concentration. Another one is analytic linguistic reasoning. And another one is emptiness. Emptiness. Emptiness means inner silence, without any thought. Without any thought. Concentration means concentrate on any image or any sound or breathe. That is concentration. That's what many types of meditation. But I strongly recommend don't do anything. When some people doing meditation, they used to ask questions, sir, that a very bad thoughts comes. A lot of thoughts at the time only comes. Don't cooperate with your thought. When you sit in a meditation, right, don't do anything. Simply comfortably sit. Suppose you say like my spine is not straight, sir. I cannot sit. Not a problem. Day by day, if I start doing, you can get afford with that, right? Get adapted to that. So you can get the help of the wall, right? And don't do anything. Whatever the thoughts comes, you just see the thoughts and laugh, right? So that is a very good one. Even you are concentrating, without concentrating, if you do that meditation, then that is good for you. So this is what my presentation regarding maintain a routine and take care of your body to get rid of coronavirus using yoga. So far I thought about the introduction of yoga. What is yoga? Yoga importance and what it can do for you. Who invented yoga, such a things, and four methodology I thought. One is yoga asana, and another one is yoga kriya, that is a purification of internal body, like colon cleaning, digestive system cleaning, nasal passage cleaning, and so on. Then we discussed about yoga mudra or hand yoga. So by using a hand, fingers, what you can do, you can change that make it into a different circuit and energy will be created. There are plenty of methodology we saw, Sin Mutra, Surya Mutra, right, Samana Mutra, such a mutras, plenty of mutras we discussed. Then thereafter we discussed about the meditation. Suppose you have people who feel, I don't want to do any yoga mutra, yoga asana, yoga kriya, then you can choose like a meditation. This is very simple. Close your eyes, be still, sit straight, and don't concentrate on anything. Then you can be in a meditation position. Sometimes what they used to say about meditation, in the sense, when you do meditation, it will tell you whether you have slept or not. When you do meditation, you feel sleepy, means that you didn't have a good sleep. So meditation will use to identify these sort of things also. So this is what meditation. Okay, so I hope everyone get benefited by this. Some of the frequently asked questions about yoga. See, some of them used to say like, sir, I am not flexible enough to do yoga. I'm not flexible enough to do yoga. Then the answer is very simple to you. If you are dirty, what will you do? Sir, I will take a bath. Similar, like if you are not flexible, yoga is for you. It will make you flexible. See, look at this man also, our prime minister also doing yoga. See, look at the lady. That's what I have put this diagram. I think her age is around 70, 65 to 70. She is capable of doing the yoga practice. To say you are not flexible enough for yoga is like saying you are too dirty to take a bath. We are what we repeatedly do. Excellence is not an act but a habit. Okay, so that's why by analyzing all the importance of yoga, this man has made that yoga international yoga day. He has made international yoga day. Suppose if you ever say, I'm busy or too busy to do yoga, then question is, are you really busy? Then this man. So this is what the question, I'm busy or too busy to do yoga. Then I can ask you a question. How many days, how many times you eat in a day? 3 times, right? Why? You feel this is the most important one, essential one. That's what you use to eat. So if you give a time to yoga, always you find time to do yoga. Yoga does not take time, it gives time. What is the difference between yoga as well as the physical exercise? Because there is always a tough questions between physical exercise and yoga. See, yoga does not need any apparatus, and you need not to do any drills. Wherever you sit, that 6 square feet is sufficient enough. 6 feet, right? 6 into 6 feet is sufficient. Square feet is sufficient enough to do this yoga. Let us see some comparisons between physical exercise, muscular related activity, and yoga. Yoga is related with your entire thing, physical, mental, social well-being. It takes care of all the three. However, physical exercise only relate with your muscular part. Very big muscular. If a person having a very big muscular, it doesn't mean he is free from disease, anxiety, stress, and so on. But if a person is very good at yoga, in the sense he is free, he is good in social well-being, physical well-being, as well as mind well-being. First one, yoga, healthy. Body temperature drops when you do yoga. But when you do physical exercise, body temperature tend to rise. Two, muscle receive minimum nutrition and oxygen and organs receive more. Because this is the correct procedure, and this is how the thing has to happen. But when you do physical exercise, muscle receive maximum nutrition and oxygen and organs receive minimum. Blood pressure and heart rate decreases when you do yoga. Blood pressure and heart rate increases when you do physical exercise. When you do yoga, encourage flexibility and capacity to adapt to the environment. Physical exercise does not. Yoga practitioners need less food than people practicing physical exercise. When you do yoga, afterwards you feel a saturation feel in terms of food or whatever the thing it may be, right? They don't feel anything. However, when they do physical exercise, you feel hungry. You feel sleepy. That's what there is a term, like yoga does not take time, it gives time. And last but not least, yoga is 99% practice and 1% is theory. Yoga is 99% practice and 1% theory. Make time for your yoga. So I recommend make time for your yoga. That's all, guys. I completed my title. The title is Maintain a Routine and Take Care of Your Body. I completed my session with this. What I wrap up is very simple. Coronavirus, that medicine can only solve disease, but it cannot give immunity system. There are many methods to increase your immunity. Yoga is the best way. Yoga not means yogasana. Yoga is a big domain. Yoga is mind, physical body, spirit, wholeness and wellness. So yoga asana, yoga kriya, yoga mudra, and meditations are 4 ways that you can attain the aim of the yoga. Yoga asana in the sense, putting your body posture in a certain posture and attain your aim of the yoga. Yoga kriya in the sense, cleaning your internal part, colon, digestive system, nasal passage cleaning. Those are all said to be the yoga kriya. Hand yoga or mudra in the sense putting your fingers in a particular electrical circuit, in a particular gusher, and the energy flows accordingly. Very simplest example is Sin Mudra, Varuna Mudra, Surya Mudra, Samana Mudra. And last, meditation. What meditation can do in the sense, it can dilute the seriousness of that thoughts. Thoughts, aggressive thoughts, kovalna varthilla. Adhalla idhala overcome panna mudiyum, meditation ala. So, transforming your mind. This is a way of transforming your mind. Guys, anyone of you having any questions? Hello? Any of you having any questions?
Participants, any queries? Sir, if there are any queries, shall we wind up, sir?
Guys, do you have any questions? Okay, madam.
Okay, sir. Actually, really, your session is very, very, very useful, sir. And you have enlightened our mind, starting from the coronavirus, its infection, and then how to overcome that situation by increasing our immunity through yoga, yoga asana, yoga kriya, mudra, and meditation. Really, sir, our participant and ourselves, I think really we have got a very good information from you. And finally, on behalf of PA College of Engineering and Technology, ICSSR and Department of CSE, I render my sincere thanks for your valuable speech, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, madam. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Participants, thanks for your listening. Varshini Parthiban, thank you for an informative session, sir. Thank you, guys. Any questions? You can interact, or suppose you are in the need of slides, I will give it to Dr. Saravana Priya and she will forward it to you too. Thank you, madam.
Thank you, sir. Participants, again, we will meet at 3:30. Stay in the link. Okay. Thank you.